slightly back. Start from the line begins with what gilui. I page confused base, about less than 10 lines down from the second section. The line begins with gilui. And we discussed the inference of the word gilui. Gilui means, as we said, just removing obstruction. Let it be revealed. There is not an extra step to create the gilui. And that is a phenomenal thing. It reveals the reality as it is in its own abode. Memara begaven hu etzem, like the appearance and the color of the etzem. Ukmoi, and as oy pnei ha'odom, the shine of the face of the person, as we know the chokhmas odom toyupon. Is a person, the wisdom of Odom, of the human being, Toyer Ponov does illuminate his face. What does that mean, it illuminates his face? This is not an extra illumination. That the oyer, the shine of his chokhmah, of his wisdom, is cognizable, identifiable, is seen by Haoris Ponov in the shine of his face. So in that situation, that the face shines up due to the wisdom that is being realized. So this shine of his face does not effectuate any kind of action, such that that it should shine and reveal. He does not engage in showing and revealing his wisdom to the outside. This is revealing his wisdom as it is unto itself. He does not produce the wisdom to be known externally. Rak only. Shemoire al etzem ha-chokhmah shebei. Shemoire, it is indicative on the etzem of his chokhmah. Etzem ha-chokhmah shebei, the etzem of his chokhmah. Why is it indicative on etzem of the chokhmah? Why not on the experience of the chokhmah? Etzem of the chokhmah means the essence of the chokhmah. Why does the Rebbe say that this is indicative on the etzem of the chokhmah? Because to effect a shine comes from an etzem. And here we will use the opposite of Kedusha to demonstrate this in you. He said, repeated several times in the past, that scientifically, quote unquote, the principle of light and the principle of vision occurs that an energy emanates from the sun and it journeys and it comes down and it hits an object. When the object resists and reverberates this energy, that goes back to the eye, and that makes you be aware of this vision of this object. In this process, there is not an element of, if we relate to this process, they themselves say there is not an element of shine, of light. There's an only element of physical energy.
What's the meaning there? There's not an element of shine, of light.
Excuse me?
What point was just made? They themselves have met that what?
That it is simply a physical reverberation. Shine.
They're describing a process in the physical world.
Even though it's sight, but they're describing it in a physical terms.
But the sciences need to deal with what's empirical, what they can measure and.
I'm not blaming them.
Right. So.
Well, I am blaming them for losing sight of what is really there, because. But what happens there is that they blind themselves to the broader reality, to the higher reality. They say all there is this physical effect.
Oh, so okay. So long as they're not claiming exclusive explanation.
Yeah, if they say, okay, we have this energy, and as a result of that, we can create a camera. Fine. But not to say that this is all the human being experiences.
Okay.
The shine is a reflection of the presence of an essential reality. What does essential mean? We tried many times to define it. It's really impossible because this is not a worldly presence. Essential, etzem, we cannot define it, but we can focus on it because we have the intelligence, the chokhmah. Essential means something that is there without any kind of process. It is not procedurally created. It is there because of its own truth. Where does that come from? This we already said yesterday. This is the divine presence. It's what's called the will, the divine will that it should be.
The shine of the face and the color. Color. Seva Gavana was also in this Geller.
That's right. This is indicative of the Etzem Chochmosi. Etzem Chochmosi means words fail to define it, but we have Seichel. Etzem Chochmosi means the source of his Chochma. What is he experiencing when he recognizes a truth? And I will resort to an example, and then we'll. If one enters this room, for example, and he sees the table set up in a certain order, does this tell him, oh, you have a way to go through this room? You have a passageway? Or does this tell him that there is something real happening here? To the extent that it also provides for a passage for human beings to participate in it. A completely different phenomenon. This is called an essential, an essence.
What there is called an essence? The fact that...
This arrangement is an anticipation. It's why this arrangement is for, not as an afterthought.
It's indicating the essence itself.
The essence itself.
So too with color?
So too, the shine of the face, not the color. The color that results from the experience, internal experience, is indicative of a fundamental internal experience. Not an experience on an experiential level, but on an essential level.
Mm. Color was not mentioned in the same context.
No, color is.
Oh,
it is. This is, if a person experiences the essence of chesed, of kindness, or he experiences the essence of gvura, his facial color changes accordingly.
Okay.
I stopped this because I wanted to attend to the words of the Rebbe. Shemoyre al etzem ha-chokhmah shebe. It is indicative of etzem ha-chokhmah, which means etzem ha-chokhmah, not the revealed chokhmah, but the essence of the chokhmah. Where does this revealed chokhmah come from? Like we are talking and talking and talking, why do we understand what we are saying? Because the words make sense, or because we have wisdom to understand what's behind these words? The answer is the second. If you don't apply that wisdom, then these words will fall on so to speak, flat on the ground. And the scientist will come and say, hey, blebberish. You're not saying anything. Let's continue. Alech ha'chokhma shebe'i. I want to skip the parentheses, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines at the end of the parentheses, line begins before the limits. We'll go back, but just want to pursue this line of thought over here.
The line starts Chacham.
The line begins with Chacham, yes. This shine is indicative of Etzem HaChacham. It's indicative not of what he understands, but what he conceptualizes. We understand the difference between conceptualization and comprehension. It's two different words. Okay, so I said I'm going to skip the parentheses for a moment. Ukmoi kein, the similar inyan, as we explained the effect of etzem ha-chokhmah, that it comes out in a shine on the face. The similar inyan ho'inyan oir ein sof. This is the similar. This is the inyan of the oir ein sof. What is oir ein sof? Reveal, talk about who, yeah, shehu bechinas gilui mino etzem levav. That this is the beginning of gilui, that's the end of gilui, revelation from the etzem. Levad means just that, not to effectuate any effect, any external effect. The beginning of gilui mino etzem, the revelation from the etzem, just that. The so that even if there were no worlds, Shaya Bechina Zu, this Bechina is applicable. because it's a gilui from the yatzer, not for any particular functional purpose. The gap, there is also this truth that bechinas ha'oed v'gilui hazeh, excuse me, we have to, this caveat is necessary to bring about, that even though this is just the gilui, revealing, you take off the cover and you see what there is. But we have to understand that bechinas ha'oed v'gilui hazeh, this oil and this revelation, it is not imperative. It is not, so to speak, something that comes automatically without intent. Rather, in fact, this is a contemplated and a willful gilui. By choice. Shekahu Ritzoyne Yizborech, that in fact this is Hashem's will. Li is Gili Oir, that there should be Gili Oir. So this is an important caveat, because this is difficult to put together. If this is, so to speak, revealing the essential truth, it should be automatic. He says that this Gili is also Ritzoyne. It is possible that there should not be any covering and not be any gilui. Except that this is Ritzoino, this is Hashem's will, that there should be gilui. No, yet still, inyan hagilui hu, the inyan and the element of this gilui is liya is his galos minu atzma. What is the meaning of gilui? That there should be gilui from the atzmos, his galos revelation from the atzmos. His galos, what his galos grammatically means, self revelation. Not an act of showing of revelation, but his galus, it's in his galus automatically. It's his galus, but the Rebbe should want that there should be a self-regulation revelation. This itself is by choice. There should be a revelation that's indicative of the Atzim itself. That itself is by choice. I hope that we, so to speak, hear the significance of this union. It's by choice. Does that mean that if there was not the choice, there would be no etzem? The etzem is there for automatic. The etzem is not there. No such thing.
Isn't the point that gilui is by choice?
This gilui is by choice, even though it's a gilui of what? Of the truth of the Atzim itself. Can the Atzim be not there? It cannot.
It could be there and not concealed, not revealed.
Okay, if it is revealed, it sounds that this is an effect of gilui, not the Atzim as it is unto itself.
Oh, you might have thought this is automatic that it's revealed?
Yeah.
Why would you?
That would be the logical thing. If it is revealed the atom the way it is unto itself. So because it's there, that's why it's revealed. That's the effect of this gilui.
You may have thought that it's by virtue of being there, it's going to be revealed.
You may think that this is the meaning of your words. Oh. You're revealing the atom. That means that it virtue of that it's there. That's why you interpret it now.
Uh-huh.
It's by choice. Mm. There's a will, a divine will, that there should be this gil. Gil yoyer. Omnom, and that's why you repeat yours back. Despite that it's a gilui ritzoni, in hagilui, the name of gilui is galus manu etzem. It does not in any which way reduce the principle of gilui as we discussed it. That is gilui mino atzmus. Gilui means from the truth of the etzem itself. This is why it is necessary. This is why here we see clearly. We have to go back and forth, because the only way we can state this truth is by going back and forth. And the only way we can understand it is resorting back to the Etzem HaChochma. In Etzem, everything is possible. Having explained this, now we can further elaborate on this. Now this is the bechina, this is the aspect of the light that was created in the first day. Somebody mentioned about the Oyesh Nivra yesterday, but he's not here today. This is the bechina of Oyesh Nivra Yimrishin. This Oyer Shenir B'Imrishin, as we discussed many times, is a unique kind of Oyer. This should be Gemara Chagigo Yud Beis Amadal. The Gemara Chagigo says, the Gemara says as follows, the Oyer B'Imrishin Yivre, light was created the first day, V'Oksiv, but does not say in the Pasuk, V'Yitan Etzem Malakim, that Hashem placed the luminaries in the sky. That's it said in the fourth day, not in the first day. So why do we say that Oyer is Nivra B'Yom Rishon? Umetareitz, and then the Gemara explains, and so to speak, rectifies this problem, this contradiction. And he says, Kirebe Lozer, that you'll explain it according to what Rebbe Lozer said. Rebbe Lozer said, the light that Hashem created the first day, Adam, Tzofe Boy. Adam. The human being, literally it means Adam Orishin. Tzofe Boy can glance with it, from the end of the world to the other end. So what is the significance of this statement? He opens his eyes and he has this light, and this light enables him to see from one end of the world to the other. Now, as we mentioned many times, worldly light that has illuminated a source cannot enable you to see from one end of the world to the other. Because there's that which should be behind you, you don't see. You can see only that which is in front of you, in front of this luminary. You say very much safely is a different kind of light. What kind of light is it? It's a light that is reflective and gilui of that which encompasses the world from one end to the other. It is not a light that is produced into the world. It's a light that encompasses the world. So very much so. He mentioned his taking a Kodesh Baruch. When HaKadosh Baruch Hu looked at this phenomenon, which means essentially that Adam is no longer a worldly creature. Omad v'gonzei. So then the Rebbe responded to this phenomenon, v'gonzei, and he retracted it. He concealed it. He put it in the treasure. V'noida, it is known, the v'yem horishen b'yematria keser. That yem horishen is b'yematria keser. What is keser? Keser means the crown. The crown is that which precedes all faculties, and is actually that which effectuate all the faculties. Crown hovers on top and encompasses everything. V'hayinu, which is bechinas ha'oyer shelamayla mihishtalshelus, which is the oyer which is above hishtalshelus. What is hishtalshelus? Hishtalshelus means something that changed down in a certain orderly way. One is different than the other. And one precedes the other, one succeeds the other. And the keser encompasses everything as one. The whole yodim orishim mabid bay besevo elam. And odim orishim was able to, he looked in through this light and he saw misevo elam from one end of the world. There was no back and forth. Front and back. The madrega zu, where in this madrega of keser, lo yesh chiluki madregas. There is no chiluki madregas, there is no different madregas. Like we explained, if we can kind of project this kind of reality, seeing in front and the back identically at the same time, there's no chiluki madrigas. I think closer or more distant. Umeir b'chol ha'olam is v'shoveh, and that shines and illuminates in all worlds equally. Ukmei sheyisboer, as we will still address this. Ubezeir chelek gimel daf resh dalet omed beis ish in zeir. It says, Nehera Kadmo, the original light, the Bore Kuchabrihu, that the Kuchabrihu that Yabasha created, have a Nohir, it illuminated, it was bright, Ad Lahava Alma Yochel Mizbali, to the extent that the world was not able to tolerate it, to bear it. V'hainu, which means she'ne be'erech o'ilomis v'akeli, it is not be'erech, it is not in proximity to the world, and not in proximity of any kelim l'kabel o'irzeh, to accept this kelim b'pchines o'epnimi as an o'epnimi. This oil cannot be absorbed in any kelim b'pchines o'epnimi, means in a manner that Oipnimi, that you should be recognized what you have. You can be absorbed by the yoy, but you cannot absorb the yoy. V'inyan omed v'gonze, and then what is the result of the fact omed v'gonze? And then Hashem responded on gonze, and he drew it back and put it in a gnizo, in a treasure. What was the treasure? What is the effect of this treasure? Kosav Bemek HaMelech. He writes in the Sefer Bemek HaMelech, Shar Vov Peyek Vites, Shenase Bebchinas Oir Maki. And then it could not be Be'epnimi, because it could not be absorbed. And then it became Be'bchinas O'epnimi, became in the quality of O'emakif. O'emakif means Eloi that encompasses rather than it being encompassed. What is the penis oil market? You don't have much time. Even if you had much time, there's very little we can say about oil market. just to say this. Remember, we were traveling from Europe, and the journey in Europe and coming from Russia and going through Europe and so forth, it was a difficult journey, it was a difficult period. People were displaced, were not established any place. And the ultimate goal was to reach America. So I remember there was one family that finally got their entrance visa to America. It was a great joy. To the extent that you could see it on the shais of their face, that they were overjoyed, they were elevated. So someone said to them, I want you to know that the sky over there and the sky over here is the same sky. The reality, ultimate reality, that which encompasses is the same, is the very same here and there, on top of the earth and on the bottom of the earth. This was kind of a human piece of wisdom, but we understand the significance of this. It has a tremendous effect. The effect of it is that it raises you above worldly distinctions. What encompasses everything? Only the divine truth. So goes it.